Hello, I'm Clemens from ExoCut. Welcome to this video tutorial. Today, you will learn how to set up and design a mockup. And all you need is the core version of DentalCut Galway, Rijeka, or higher. No further models are required. Before we start step by step, let's talk about the new possibilities this indication has to offer to you. First, you can create a clip-on. No prep, no margin, no minimum thickness is required. Just your design followed by a hard cut to the model. And second, designing a virtual walk-up to create a design in advance for handling complex cases later. Third, a mock-up model. We merge the digital design and the original model into just one watertight mesh. The first two options I will show you now. In a separate video tutorial, you can see the mock-up model later. Now let's start right away designing a mock-up using this My Creator and mock-up sample, and afterwards you will get more detailed insights about advanced options and parameters. Let's go! The indication mock-up works great in combination with the My Creator, a game-changing option but not mandatory for our mock-up. This topic will be addressed separately in a different video tutorial. We like to define the insertion direction from view to create the necessary retention areas to hold the mockup in place. Therefore, we rotate the view to a direction the patient would use for inserting the prototype. With a click, we set the insertion from view to evaluate if the undercuts that have been highlighted in red would be enough to hold the mockup in place. For now, we apply the default parameters to generate a virtual walk-up bottom to continue. And later I will explain all the parameters in detail. If desired, you can make use of the freeforming tab. By removing blocked out material, you ensure the best possible fit. You can place the teeth from our library with two clicks on the distal areas and modify this draft by moving the contact points if necessary. Also, you can select your preferred library in the drop-down menu or by clicking on the arrow keys next to it. For this case, I like to choose the Exofan library. I then click on Next to do the setup in more detail. Now we can access the full power of modern tooth placement. We start by using the chain mode, which is a great way to resize all teeth together and divide the available space evenly. Here I choose the free axis selection scaling to individualize the tooth setup one by one. If you have further questions regarding the tooth placement that have been introduced with 3.0 Galway, you can find a dedicated tutorial addressing this topic in the description. If you want to modify specific details, like cervical or interdental, you can freeform them right away without leaving this step. To do this, we select the Instant Anatomic Freeform tool. But keep in mind, there's one thing we can't know right now. The thickness of our design. You will see that especially on the canines after I clicked on Next. We implemented a color indicator to visualize if the desired mockup thickness has been realized. Remember, you defined 0.2 mm at the beginning. Because we used an insertion direction ideal for a vestibular clip-on, everything below 0.2 mm and what we can't reach palatal will be displayed pink. This is how we know exactly the transition where we should add material to strengthen the thin mockup or where we are free to make changes without concerns. Keep in mind that we have no layer of minimum thickness like a crown or bridge. Therefore, we can create a hole inside the structure if there is no material at all. If you design a virtual walk-up or mockup model, this visualization is not that essential. For a clip-on, on the other hand, this is a great advantage. The tab 3 gives you the freedom to add, remove and smooth material to address the details. For example, in between the teeth. Also, we add material to the incisal edge to achieve a perfect alignment with the natural teeth. After our setup is almost ready, we adapt occlusal and proximal areas one by one by clicking on Cut Intersections. The next step will give us the possibility to connect all six objects. I select Join Tooth Shapes directly as connector geometry and click on Apply. By clicking on Multiview Design, we get a detailed split view from every connection. Clicking on Next starts the calculation of our virtual walkup. In addition, all teeth are also saved individually without connectors as digital tooth models. To create a clip-on mockup, one more action will be necessary. So then we proceed with the next step to do the so-called hard cut. This new operation will only be available with a work type mockup selected in the DentalDB. This performs a direct cut from the jaw scan to the reconstruction. The occlusal view shows how the palatinal area is affected due to the insertion direction. To check the results, you can hide the jaw scan to see the bottom of the mockup we created successfully. A look inside with a cut view reveals a watertight and single object ready to manufacture. That was an easy and intuitive workflow, right? And how you can create a 3D printed physical mockup model, we will show you in a separate video tutorial. But if you like to learn more about additional options and parameters, stay with me and have now a more detailed look into it. Advanced options and parameters. Let's have a closer look into our DentalDB. The work type mockup has been selected. The green circles indicate that connectors will be placed, but you can deactivate them anytime with a click to manufacture multiple objects. Also, multiple options are available to you. The first option gives us the great possibility to extract teeth virtually when they have not been extracted yet. Here you can see how that option looks like. If you activate this option, the wizard will offer this step in the beginning to perform the extraction before we start the design. Virtual gingiva. Especially if several teeth have been extracted, a virtual gingiva may be necessary to replace the lost tissue as well. If you know already that you want to do it, you can pre-select yes, so it will be part of the step-by-step routine. Both options will be explained in detail in separate video tutorials. Advanced parameters. Let's have a closer look at the available parameters here and continue this topic in the DentalCAD Virtual Walkup bottom step. The first parameter is the minimum thickness and it's set to 0.2 mm. If you fear that the construction will become too fragile, you can add material here. But keep in mind that we have no layer of minimum thickness like we do have on crowns or bridges. Therefore, this parameter is used only for visualization purposes. The advanced parameters provide you the flexibility to set your professional preferences as default. Every change you make here will be suggested in the future, if you select the same client, material, and indication. That's why the adjusted parameters show up as highlighted to indicate that you changed them. You can always reset values to material defaults. On the other hand, if you change parameters inside the DentalCAD, it won't remember your preferences for further cases. Let's have a closer look at DentalCAD in the Virtual Walkup bottom step. Offset controls the digital spacer, which is laid on the model, in this case 30 microns. Smoothing will add more blocked out material into concavities. The larger the number, the smoother it will be. Consider tool diameter. This value affects the space around the sharp incisal edges and depends on your specific manufacturing process. In case you choose a CNC machine, the ideal parameter for milling depends on the size of the smallest burr used for milling the bottom. Here, it's beneficial to choose a value slightly higher than the diameter of the actual tool you are using. For example, choose 1.2 mm when milling with a 1 mm tool to ensure a perfect fitting without losing too much space. Therefore, this spacer should not be used unnecessarily if a 3D printer is doing the job instead. In this case, this value should be reduced to 0.1 mm. Let's continue with the blocked out undercuts tab. The angle specifies the amount of draft angulation in relation to the insertion axis. And the low undercuts up to regulates the maximum amount of retention. Higher values will increase the depth of the area of retention, resulting in a stronger fit. But take into account, strong undercuts may result in tension on the teeth and could damage the thin mock-up. Now you know all the parameters in detail to manufacture a beautiful and precise mock-up. And you will benefit from what you learned today also if you're creating a bite splint or anatomical bite splint bottom, because there you will see all these parameters again. We hope you have enjoyed this video tutorial and to see you soon.